In the last few weeks, I've been supporting the local health workers and NHS staff, the only way I know how really, with massive lasers. Projecting messages of support onto local landmarks in Brighton, but also giving local residents the chance to operate these big lasers through their mobile phones. And that's got me thinking about what could I make as a lockdown light show. If that sounds like something you'd be interested in, then stick around. It's been a very strange time, and for me, it's been a period of readjustment. Like, all of my work has been cancelled. Like, my project to replace fireworks has been cancelled. I was initially very focused on the protective gear for health workers, and I was 3D printing and designing some of that stuff. But I thought, wouldn't it be good to figure out a way if I could use my lasers to provide people with a bit of entertainment in these rather strange times? The only lasers that I have on hand are these relatively small ones. You can see here I've got a 3-watt Able laser with very fast scanners in, and that's a laser that went on tour with Matt Parker and for Beck Hill's show in Edinburgh. More about that in future videos. But I also had three of these small, physically small lasers. They're made by a Chinese company called OPT or Opt Laser, but they're actually 4 watts, so they're pretty powerful. Not the most powerful lasers I had, and obviously for doing big outdoor things, I could have done with my 12-watt RGBs, but they're all I've got at home at the moment, so that's what I used. And actually, it gave me a bit of impetus to do some modifications on them. Added a powercon through and also a 12 volt output. If that's something you'd be interested in knowing more about, then hit me up in the comments and I'll do a video about that too. If I want to point powerful lasers into the sky, then I've got to let the authorities know about it. The first people I need to contact are the CAA, the Civil Aviation Authority. It turns out it's a relatively straightforward process. You use the same form that you use if you're putting on a fireworks display or if you're releasing a load of balloons. I don't know who still does that. But it's a very matter-of-fact thing, and normally they would ask for 4 weeks' notice, but this time I let them know the day before, and I guess they don't have very much to do at the moment, because the very next day I could see on the NOTAM map that I had been given clearance. I also let the police know through the online forms for registering an event, so they knew what to expect. Where I live, it's quite lucky because I have a kind of roof terrace thing and I can see right across Brighton to the sea. I'm using laser controllers called Ether Dreams. They run off a network, so I've got a lot of network gear set up. I usually like to use proper lighting stands, but I don't have any to hand, so I just had to make sure that the lasers were mounted on a properly sturdy surface. There was no chance of them moving into unexpected areas. Once I got all the lasers set up, it was time to do some basic alignment. With this setup, I have to be quite careful because I'm pointing at a building, so I want to make sure that there's no chance of getting the laser through the windows. Although, having said that, a laser of this power is pretty safe by the time it's reached that far. I started pretty simple with just the NHS logo on this tower block. It's called Sussex Heights, perfect white building for projecting onto. And that's the Able laser because it's got so much better scanners. Then with the 4-watt lasers, I projected strong beams into the sky. For outdoor stuff, 4 watts probably isn't enough if you want beams, but I could put 3 of them together and they were just about visible enough. And then for the most recent installation, I decided to target the Brighton Tower called the I360. It's about 800 metres away from me. I'm not the only laserist doing this. It turns out there's laserists all over the country that want to show their support for the NHS. This was actually a really nice experience, and it was just something that reminded me that people want a bit of fun in their lives, something a bit spectacular. Anyway, it got me thinking, couldn't I make a light installation that was perfect even if we're in lockdown? I've called it Laser Light City, and I'm planning to get hold of the biggest lasers, probably 30 watt lasers, and install them in various cities in the UK. And it's perfect for the light festivals who currently don't know whether they can go forward or not. It's not quite certain that they have to cancel fully, but then they don't really want to go ahead with any bookings either. If I can give them something that can be installed on buildings across the city and perhaps reach hundreds of thousands of people, then that's something I can offer them. So that's why I started playing with an interactive system. So you can see here, I've set it up so that you can connect to my website with your phone and control the laser beams in real time. That's something I'm planning on working on throughout the summer. This was just a little bit of fun, and it was my way of saying thank you to the NHS. These people are doing incredible work, but it's not just for these weird times. We really should take great care of these essential workers and provide funds and support to them all year round. I'm certainly glad that I could make my own very small expression of support. So a quick channel update. Thanks to the Tom Scott collaboration, I got thousands of new subscribers, so welcome to the channel. I'd love to hear from you. What kind of thing are you interested in? There are actually loads of questions and incorrect statements in the comments on Tom's video, so if you want to know more about that stuff, if you've got any more questions about that, I'll happily do an FAQ just for that video. Yes, but thank you so much for subscribing, and I'll see you on the next one.